Two suspects, Julian Cater and George Tanios, worked together to assault U.S. Capitol Police Officer Brian Sicknick and other officers with an unknown toxic chemical spray. That's according to an FBI agent's detailed statement in court records. Cater from Pennsylvania and Tanios from West Virginia have been arrested and charged with 9 counts total. The case of Sicknick, who died of injuries suffered in the January 6th attack on the Capitol, has been a top priority for investigators.
This is a huge development in this case, and it's clear that it took a long time for law enforcement to get to this point.
Details of the alleged assault are jarring. In court papers, an FBI agent cites videos taken at between 2:09 p.m. and 2:23 p.m. on January 6th on the west side of the Capitol. On the videos, court papers say, Cater walks toward Tanios and says, quote, "Give me that bear S," and reaches into Tanios' backpack. Tanios replies, "Hold on, hold on. Not yet, not yet. It's still early." The filing says Cater then tells Tanios, quote, "They just effing sprayed me." About 9 minutes later, court papers say, a police officer's body camera caught Cater discharging spray into the faces of Sicknick and 2 other officers from just a few feet away.
One of them has already said to the FBI agent who was an affiant for the complaint that it was worse than any pepper spray that they'd been exposed to when they were in law enforcement training.
The officers recoiled, court papers say, tried to get water to wash out their eyes. They were temporarily blinded by the substance, the agent wrote, and were unable to perform their duties for at least 20 minutes. One officer reported scabbing that remained on her face for weeks. Law enforcement officials have said Sicknick went back to a police command center and collapsed. He died the next day. Cater and Tanios are charged with assault, not murder, because investigators still haven't determined with certainty that the exposure to the spray directly caused Sicknick's death.
They are keenly focused on trying to find the right evidence to fully understand how he lost his life. Trying to understand what was that, you know, singular moment. We may not get to that, but I think we have to look at this officer's engagement throughout the day of defending the U.S. Capitol.
One former prosecutor says if authorities can't bring murder or manslaughter charges against these defendants, they still have one powerful weapon in court.
The other 2 officers are witnesses. You are also going to have 2 officers who are going to say, I was sprayed in the face with a chemical substance.
Julian Cater's defense attorney says he plans on pleading not guilty. Meanwhile, tonight, Wolf, prosecutors have new information on alleged rioter Timothy Hale Cusinelli, who faces 7 criminal counts in connection with the Capitol riot. Prosecutors say Hale Cusinelli, who's an Army reservist, was a well-known white supremacist and Nazi sympathizer at the Navy base where he worked as a contractor. They say that he often promoted racist and sexist views against Jewish people, minorities, and women, and that he was even rebuked for wearing a Hitler style mustache. His defense attorney says that Hale Cusinelli denies being a white supremacist.